The David Pipe Train Great Endeavour leapt to the head of the Hennessy anti-post market with a decisive win in the Paddy Power Gold Cup. Who can stop him emulating the same connection Celestial Gold, who did the double in 2004? Race analysts Dave Orton and Mark Brown join me to look at the opposition. 1833, Paul Nichols, trainer with a great record in the race, second season chaser, they've got a great record in the race, but you're keen to oppose this horse.
As you say, traditionally it's the novices from last season who you want to look towards. For me though, I don't see why he's much shorter in the betting than Wymot and Wayward Prince. Certainly on form, there's no reason why he should be, and he's conceding weight to both of those. For all that, he looked good on occasions last year, including when winning twice at this course over fences. He was already struggling when hampered and pulled up in the RSA. He made a satisfactory comeback behind Summersby at Kempton over an inadequate trip. I can see why people are fancying him. And as you say, Nichols, you have to respect him in this race. But I think he's on a mark of 150, and that'll be tough enough to defy.
And Dave, you're keen to oppose him as well.
I agree with that. We knew, actually, that the Sun Alliance wasn't going to be his race, didn't we? I think everyone seemed to know that. He drifted and ran abysmally.
Yeah.
They had been talking for a long time about going for this year's Hennessy. In fact, Nichols was very excited about him last year. The comeback run was decent. Ruby's presumably going to be on him. The mark is perhaps not insurmountable, but the hustle and bustle of the big field, that's a problem. He loves Newbury. We saw that last season. Couldn't hardly won any easier, could he? When he won. And he is, again, he's an improving sort. There's no doubt about that. It's just something about him. He doesn't really quicken either. And unless he's up there, which with Ruby on him, you can't really see. Then, again, there's just something that makes me want to take him on. The handicap mark against those that he'll be racing on is probably just against him. And like Mark says, if it wasn't Ruby and Nichols, you wouldn't be with him.
What about second favourite, Wayward Prince, placed in the RSA last year?
Yeah, he was. He ran a blinder in that race last year. He showed himself to be a real tough and progressive novice chaser, winning the Grade 2 up at Wetherby. He stays very well. He was disappointing on his final run, a bit for me, at Aintree, where he wore a first-time visor. They're not going to go with the headgear this time. He's a sort of horse I could see plodding on, finishing third or fourth, but I'll be expecting something with a bit more pace to beat him.
Would you be opposing him as well?
I like him a lot. I was never really with him last year. I knew he was a decent hurdler. He won that Grade 1 at Aintree. Everyone thought it was a shock. It obviously wasn't. The Aintree run, I think we can forget that. I think he had a very hard race at Cheltenham. The visor's a weird one. I couldn't work out why they put it on. They could well regret that.
You can see why he can be a bit of a lazy so-and-so, and he does stay
though,
very well.
He?
Maybe just wanted to sharpen him up because he can get caught out.
He's tough, but again, we've mentioned this before, horse's second time headgear, I'm sure that he won't be wearing it first time up.
He's not.
It's a bit odd, isn't it, when you look back in a really decent horse's form, do you see them having had a bad run in headgear?
No.
You don't really, but he's a solid novice. He's better handicapped in my mind than 1833. He's on the same mark of 150.
Yeah.
And you can see that he's been aimed at the race. Ian Williams is perfectly adept at doing this. And I think he must be one of the each way certainties in the race.
Way, certainly. What about John Cole? Probably not one of those that fits the trend so much, but look back to form last time out.
Yeah, he did. He's a monster of a horse, as most people know. Very consistent. He stays well. He goes in any ground. You're probably more of an expert on this horse than me, but I think it wouldn't surprise me. I think he's on 11 stone 6 in the race, is he? Something like that. I could see him running a good race.
He's a beast. Obviously, at this point, we don't know what the top weight will be. It's probably going to be something of Nichols. It could be Neptune, couldn't it, or something like that. He's going to be up the top of the weights. Excuse me. His comeback run was fantastic, actually. He beat Kuldine, who a couple of years back everyone thought was the next big thing from Willie Mullins' race. He's another interesting one, and we'll get to that in just a second. John Cole was doing all of his best work late on. They said he might need it. He is a stuffy horse. There's no bigger fan than me of Paul Nolan. I think he's an outstanding trainer. If he lines up, again, he's very hard to knock out the frame. The official mark is the problem. You've got to go back to Denman when he first won it. We all know what he did afterwards. That was 161. John Cole is on 164. It's a very good race this year. Is he a Gold Cup horse? He is of that calibre, isn't
he's
he?
That
when
caliber.
He's right, he's going to probably have his ground. He should get round fine. He's, again, very tough. He'll be staying on late, but then probably will be just something too speedy at the end for him.
And you say he might not turn up. There's a few others that fit that category. We've got Time for Rupert. We've got Weird Al, first and second in the Charlie Hall. Also Diamond Harry, last year's winner. If they did take their chance, would you fancy any of those three?
I'd be really keen on Diamond Harry again. I know he's on a £10 higher mark now, but he won a better race last year with a lot in hand. So he beat Burton Port, the RSA runner-up. I felt Burton Port's RSA was a stronger RSA than last year. as I say, he's £10 higher, but he's shown he can go well fresh. He obviously had to miss the Charlie Hall. I get the impression they're going to go for the Betfair, but if he did turn up, I would not be at all shocked to see him go back to back.
And Dave, any of those three that you'd fancy if they did take their chance?
Something about Diamond Harry, it's funny, isn't it? As a novice over hurdles, I was a big fan of his. Again, another big horse. He just needs everything to go right for him.
He loves Newbury, I think that's the
he does love Newbury. He's going to be a lot higher, isn't he, than when he won last year.
£10 higher.
That's the other thing. So, again, he's got the mark against him. I'd be surprised if there wasn't something slightly further down the weights. A lot of people were disappointed with Time for Rupert when he made his comeback in the Charlie Hall. Not me. I was expecting... I said... At that Sun Alliance flop, I couldn't believe it. My jaw was firmly on the floor. I just could not believe how badly he ran. I said then and there, I will not back him first time up. I went totally against that rule. Got 4-1 for the Charlie Hall, and for a lot of the race, I thought I was on the winner. I was actually more impressed with that comeback run, given his problems, than he'd had. I don't think he's going to turn up for this, though. He's probably going to go for the Betfair Chase. Again, that's going to be a tough ask against a long run, but he's definitely a horse for this season.
Okay, so looking further down the list, any slightly bigger prices that are immediately jumping out at you?
For all that, I don't think last year's RSA was the strongest of runnings compared to recent years. Of the second season chases, I'd fancy Wymot to come out on top of Wayward Prince at 18.33. He beat Wayward Prince over hurdles at Haydock a couple of years ago. He's a bit of a lazy sort, but he stays very well. He won his first three over fences. He was pulled up in the RSA where he wore first-time cheek pieces, but it subsequently emerged he'd fractured a cannon bone or something like that, so we can completely ignore that. Trevor Hemmings has got a fine record in the race, won it with Trebolgan, Burton Port runner-up last year. Wouldn't be at all surprised if he turned up and ran a big race here for Donald McCain, who's emerged as a leading trainer.
Well, you mentioned Wymot, and again, that kind of goes back to what I was saying about Time for Rupert. We've got to take on trust that he's going to line up A1, haven't we? Again, he's in the right hands to do so. Yes. But again, there's a leap of faith there, isn't there? If you go back to his previous form, again, there's a lot to like about these Trevor Hemmings horses. They're tough, aren't they? And they keep grinding it out. You need a grinder, you know, for a Hennessy, it's got to be done. You talked about Time for Rupert. Sarando was uber impressive on his comeback. A lot of people thought at Aintree, at the Grand National meeting, that he was a bit of a fluky run there. But the winner, Quito de la Roque, probably a live outsider over the Gold Cup, came back and won it at the weekend at Downroyal on his reappearance. He was so impressive at Carlisle. I was on the runner-up that day and I couldn't believe four out. I knew I was beat. Aikman was that horse. He's a decent animal. He thrashed him.
He just kept going, didn't he? He just kept galloping relentlessly.
He goes on any ground. He goes on any ground. He's, again, a second-season chaser. He's got a £4 penalty that brings him in. He's just nicely in down there. And I think that I can't let him go unbacked. I think he's going to be a big improver. He's a bit of a dark one. He's gone under people's radars a little bit. But I like his chances.
Okay, so that's Sarando for Dave. Another that you like, I know, Michel Le Bon. Intriguing runner for Paul Nicholls.
Yes, from the same connections as 1833. I backed this for the RSA in 2009 when he hosed up at Newbury, didn't he?
Yeah,
straight away afterwards, and he was still around about 16-1 for the RSA, and I backed him, and of course he went missing. Typical anti-post tail. And I promised myself that if he ever made it back, I'd be with him. He's very lightly raced. He's only been beaten twice. He's got some decent form in his bag. He's really, really well bred. He looks all over a stayer, and I'm not too worried about the absence. A lot of Hennessy winners these days are first-time outers, aren't they?
It's a big absence, though, isn't it?
It's a big absence, but again, if it was anyone else, you would sort of go, yes. But again, at the prices, around about 16-1, he's my idea of the likely winner of the race.
What about the lack of experience? Would that be a concern?
Possibly, but again, it's Nicholls. They all schooled so superbly, and he's won at the track, which is the main thing.
Okay, and looking at further down the list, one at a massive price I know you're fairly keen on.
Planet of Sound, Philip Hobbsey's runner. He won a big Grade 1 at Punchestown back in 2010. He's a horse who prefers good ground, so I'll be hoping that it doesn't get too testing at Newbury. But Newbury's a track he's won at on numerous occasions.
He does.
He's well weighted on his Betfair Chase third last season behind Imperial Commander, who won the Gold Cup the year before. Philip Hobbs has won the race before. He feels he's got him right this year. He felt he never quite had him 100% last time round. But of what is potentially a decent mark for a horse who we could see improvement from, he's still relatively lightly raced for his age. He'll be staying, he stays a trip certainly very well. He'll be up in trip now. Philip Hobbs has always thought of him as a potential stayer, and I think back in the day he even mentioned him as a potential national horse one day. So stamina shouldn't be a problem, and at what was 33, so it'll be shorter now, but I think he's well worth taking a punt on.
He's won first time up as well,
hasn't he? He goes well fresh.
He won the Holden Gold Cup, didn't he?
That's right.
And then he went on to much bigger and better.
He's a class for a Grade One winner. He's not on a bad mark at all. So
ground is key, though, I would say.
The ground is key. He acts with a little bit of cut. Good to soft, I'd be happy still. But if it became soft, virgin, and much worse than that, then I'd probably look elsewhere. Well,
talking of ground, we mentioned Coldine earlier in the same breath as John Cole. If you look at John Cole's comeback run, the moral winner for me that day was Coldine. He went a terrible year last year, didn't he? Nothing went right for him. Again, Mullins has made positive notes about him. There's a rumour about him going over the National, which would be of some concern. But he's going to be so much better off now with John Cole. Mm. If you like John Cole, you've got to like Coldine.
Yeah, that's the coming to it, isn't he?
And he's a real tough horse, that one.
He is.
He goes on any ground, particularly when it's mud flying.
Former RSI.
And off 150, same 151 is his Irish mark now, I think, something like that. They dropped him £3 for that because John Cole was pulling away from him so far at the end, but he needed it. And again, for me, he's the same connections of B Mile Royal, the disqualified winner.
That's right.
In Ginjombra's year. Willie Mullins in a big handicap. Again, he's a big price at around about 20-1.
Yeah, so would you be prepared to put him up at this stage?
Definitely in my top four, without a doubt.
Okay, well, to sum up then, we'll get the selections from you guys. Mark, Planet of Sound?
I'll go with Planet of Sound, take a bit of a punt. If he turns up, I'll have Diamond Harry as the alternative and Wymop to fare best of the second season chasers.
Okay, and for you, Dave?
I'm going to take a punt on Michelle Le Bon, another price-wise horse, but again, I just think he is the potential real class horse in the race. It will go one way or the other, but at the prices I can take him. I think Wayward Prince will be there at the end. I think Sarando, again, is another each-way price, and I won't be able to let John Cole and Coldine, I'll have a very little bit on them, but definitely Michelle Le Bon for me.